So hello and welcome everyone to yet another School Synergy Workshop Series session with us. I am Ruchi Kumar, working in Center for Excellence in Teacher Education at TISS Mumbai. And I'm really very happy to see such a nice participation in our workshop series. We have been doing this workshop series since 2019, first in the face-to-face mode and ever since pandemic in an online mode. Almost every week we are meeting from 3 to 4 on Saturday, except yes, we have taken a few breaks, but it has been really nice. And it's nice to see that we have on Telegram also, we have more than 500 teachers who have joined our community and engage in discussion even after the sessions have taken place. And this is what our objective was. We wanted to create a space where researchers, teacher educators, teachers, they all can share their ideas. We can discuss ideas which can directly be implemented in practice. We can share our experience of working in this education space with each other. And I'm so glad that we have had these kind of opportunities. This semester, we are starting yet another edition in the sense that we have now two sessions for each theme. So today, for example, we will be having a session on how videos can be used to develop reflection for teachers. And next week, we have a teacher sharing sessions in which we will be expecting you all as teachers to contribute your ideas about the same theme. So today we are very, very fortunate to have with us Uma Kogekar, who is from CK. And it is a wonderful organization who have been creating videos, working with teachers, providing them continuous professional development, working with teachers to develop right from the lesson plan to the idea of how video will be done, generating the video, editing it, and then releasing on the sites. And how those the process of making videos itself and the process of watching videos has really helped teachers in reflecting on their teaching. And it is not just their own teaching that when they see through videos, they see other people's video also, and that also help them to reflect on their teaching. So without much further ado, I ask Uma Kogekar to please start addressing ourselves. Uma, very, very welcome to you.
Thank you so much, Ruchi, and I'm really excited to be here today. And it's wonderful to see that the moment we became live, we already have over 100 participants. So I'm a little bit nervous because I don't think I have spoken to so many people who TISS has gathered together through their Synergy workshops. But I hope that the session will be interactive and useful for everyone. I'd give a very quick introduction about the work that we are doing. I think Ruchi, you'd already mentioned it. So I work at the Center for Equity and Quality in Universal Education. So this is a 10-year-old nonprofit, and we work purely work in teacher capacity development. Now, these teachers come from Zilla Parishad schools, they come from municipal schools, Nagarpalika, Anudanit, government-aided schools, as well as low-income private schools. So over the last 9 years, we've worked with close to some 500 to 600 teachers directly, and almost, I think, 20,000 teachers indirectly through our other programs where we work with school leaders. As part of the work that we do, use videos very centrally to help teachers improve their teaching practice. And that is what I'm here to talk to you about and to share our experiences in using videos very centrally in our processes. The way we are going to do this today, and I'm going to speak a lot about I'm going to give you a lot of examples of the experiences we've had over the years in working with teachers. I'll try to divide the sessions into 2-3 parts. We are actually together going to look at some videos, and you're going to get an opportunity to observe and give your feedback and your understanding of what is actually happening in the class. We are going to take two videos which are in language. They're actually going to be in Marathi and Hindi mixed. But I think you'll be able to get the general flow for those of you who don't understand Marathi at all. And I'll be happy to switch between Marathi, Hindi, and English throughout this session. So coming back to, and after we've deconstructed everything, we'll also talk about what we call as a noticing framework. And post that, we'll come to some questions which the audience may have. So let me back up a little bit. So the program that we run is known as the Teacher Innovator Program. And it's a year-long program where teachers enroll and they learn new and innovative methods of teaching. And they take these methods and they try and use them in class according to a curricular plan. And then as coaches, as CK, we go there and the coaches at our organization go and observe the teachers and they try and see how far have the classrooms been transformed? Are the classrooms really becoming learning classrooms? What are the difficulties the teacher is facing in implementing any given strategy in class? At the end of all of this process, the teacher comes back to us with a lesson idea, which is usually very different or innovative. Even in small ways, it may be innovative. It may be in the way she's forming groups. It may be in the way she's using a particular type of material, a teaching aid. We take these lesson ideas from the teachers, and then we sit with her and we ask her how she's going to execute this in class. And at the end of that process, when she submits this plan to us, we do a professional shoot of her lesson. One of the things that we're very particular about is none of the lessons are scripted. They are live and as the teacher has thought about, implementing in class. And then they're sort of edited into short videos of 5 to 7 minutes and released on our YouTube channel. So Ruchi, maybe somebody can put it on the chat box later. So it's a youtube.com/teacherpages. So if anyone is interested in looking at those videos, find them there. And we have almost about 150 videos of teacher practice there. So videos as a tool, when we look at it as a tool, we've always seen videos of, of good teaching practices or of exemplars. So in the past, we would have videos which were perhaps shot in a studio where there will be somebody telling you, okay, here's how you teach. It's almost the entire thing is scripted. The entire thing is an exemplar of best practice, but shot not necessarily in the classroom. There are another set of videos which we know and a lot of perhaps other organizations such as TESS India as well, where we are looking at videos which are used as a tool of everyday, of recording everyday practice of the teachers. So just as a teacher goes regularly in a classroom and teaches a lesson and you take a film of that, and then that's where we are looking at videos as a recording of everyday practice to deconstruct teaching and learning practices. The second part which we are talking about is something sort of newer, where we are looking at now using everyday practice, the recording of everyday practice as a tool for improving your learning and your for noticing what is actually happening in a classroom. Videos can be actually used for multiple purposes. So it's not just that you are using video for self-reflection. You can use video as a tool for collaboration. So you could actually have teachers share their own classroom video with other peers in their school or perhaps others, such as the kind you're telling Ruchi that you have a lot of teachers in the Telegram group. So it's almost like they form a community and they share with each other. So it's also a tool for collaboration. And it's also a tool for coaching, which is what we as an organization have been doing, using videos as a tool for coaching. And the last sort of use of a video is also for evaluation, where you might, at a school leadership level, if you want to look at how teachers have progressed over a certain period of time, then you can observe at certain points in time, their video recordings, and then perhaps figure out what kind of support a teacher needs. So these are some 3 or 4 different ways in which videos can be used. I'm going to now sort of pause over here and I'm going to share a video which is, I think, being shot in a Zilla Parishad school. I know it is in a Zilla Parishad school, somewhere in, I think in Chandrapur. And this video, this lesson is actually in Marathi. But even so, I will pause at certain times in case, Ruchi, and you can also tell me if you feel that, it's getting too complex to understand. But it's a very simple video, and I think in the second or the third standard. What I want the audience to do as I play the video is to note down what the teacher is doing and what the children are doing. This is the two things that you need to write down. And post that, we'll have a little bit of a discussion on what were some of the observations. So I'm going to share the video now. And Ruchi, tell me in case, it's not visible or you can't hear.
Remember to share the sound.
Yes. It's asking me for a password though.
Just do it like the last time you did.
I didn't do anything. Sharing now?
Yeah. We can see it now. You can go full screen.
Yes.
Yeah.
Yes. So I'll just repeat that this is a lesson, actual shooting that has happened inside a classroom. And you need to record what you see the teacher doing and what you see the students doing.
Yeah. Just to remind everyone, I have also posted the YouTube link in the chat box. You can save that. Go ahead.
Okay. दीदी के साथ शेयर करेंगा।
I'm going to stop sharing now, Richie. And let's have a little bit of, what people have noticed so far. And I'll again play a little bit section later. But could we have, you could either put it on the chat box or if anybody would like to speak.
I would like to say, it was a very interactive session with the children. The teacher is trying to interact properly with the children, and definitely the student ratio is less, so it is easy to interact. But when we have a class of 40 to 50, it is very difficult to interact with each child. But since, you have a smaller group, so you can easily sit down and be at ease and, show the book, and they can see also, and everybody can be an attentive audience. And the same with the teacher, she's so particular about it that each one is looking at her and eye to eye contact is there, and everybody's enjoying it.
All right. So you said that it was a very interactive session.
Yeah.
Would you like to tell me in what way you found it interactive?
Interactive in the sense she was, whatever she explained first, then she immediately looked at the book and she did it. I couldn't understand Marathi. So whatever I could understand from there was, then she showed the book and she kept on showing the pictures and all that. And then the children were supposed to be answering back. And then again, between the children, she was asking things so that they are attentive. All the time they were listening to the teacher.
All right. Thank you. Thank you so much. Let's see what some others have to say. Someone
Uma, there is a lot of responses on the chat. Do you want me to read it out?
Yes, please, because I can see there is
There is some Sonia Singh saying signposting, questioning, using flashcards and recapitulations. So, I think... Yeah, so that very technical terms that she know of, and on the basis of previous knowledge, she starts set induction. Then one was saying multiple formats of learning being used, reading, discussing, writing, interactive process. Then teacher is talking continuously to the students and showing the book. Then a nice way to deal with teaching methodologies, both way communication. So what I'm seeing is that some are looking at the teacher's point of view, in the sense that teacher is continuously explaining or asking, and other people are seeing it as an interactive process. Yes. That is in itself quite interesting, that the same thing is being interpreted in two different ways. Yeah.
What is also interesting is that there are a lot of terms, Ruchi, that are coming, like a child-centered approach or interaction or interactive. So it's important to understand what each one of us means by interactive. Someone had also said that it's all happening very properly. So what is proper?
There are lots of people have raised hands. So I'm going to call one by one. Suram Ram Mohan Rao, can you please unmute and speak?
Good afternoon, madam.
Yes, go ahead.
Madam, the class is very good. It is only for primary sections, not for the higher classes. And it is for only limited students of students. I like the class very much because so much is written on the walls. The walls are very beautifully painted. And the teacher is what she is doing. She is sitting with the children. And when she is using the standing and using blackboard, simultaneously she is asking children, and I think a primary teacher needs all the things.
Right. So can I ask you another question?
Based on your
Okay, madam.
So you said very nicely that you saw that there were a lot of things on the walls, right?
Yes, ma'am.
You also noticed that the teacher was standing and all that. Did you notice how the lesson started? Do you recall anything? What happened at the beginning of the lesson?
Something she shown to the children, that one object, she wrote on blackboard. Then only she used the textbook.
Correct. And when she began, you're right, she wrote something on the blackboard and you know she was just settling down. And then I think she sort of picked up the textbook.
So yes, ma'am. Middle of the lesson, she took the textbook. Actually, she started with, I think it is my mind. First, she tested their previous knowledge and used some object. I don't know, but what it may be. Oh, and okay. After asking the questions, she continued the lesson.
Right. So, okay. So, thank you. Let's see whether anyone wants to add to what you're saying. Right?
Revati Wali, if you want to add something to this, you have 1 minute. Yeah.
Yeah. Hi. Good afternoon, everyone. I felt this looks like more of traditional teaching methods that were used by the teacher, probably because of the situation. It was a Zilla Parishad school, so I can understand that maybe the kind of technology that is available in the urban areas may not be available there. But nevertheless, the observations done by most of the people here are true. The fact that, yes, traditional approach of teaching learning method was used where the teacher used the set induction. Yes.
I would like you to explain a little bit what you
mean. Yes, Uma, please.
What you mean by traditional. Because I think a lot of people said that it was a wonderful interactive classroom. And you're actually saying something slightly different. You're saying that it was traditional. So in your mind, what is it that you noticed which is leading you to this inference that it is a traditional classroom?
If you could speak. I can see, yes, I could see that the teacher is focusing on the fact that she comes from where the, it is from the teacher, the knowledge is shared from the teacher to the student, rather than eliciting from the students themselves, you see.
She was asking.
So when I'm looking at,
she was asking, right?
It is a teacher. Yes, I agree. Questioning was used, but then it was more of observation. You just observe through the textbook. Using the textbook is also one way of, you know, inferring that it is traditional more than the new age technology. Right.
So,
I can say.
So Revati's has arrived at the inference that it is a traditional classroom because she noticed that the teacher has relied a little bit heavily on the textbook. Is that right, Revati? If I understand you.
That's right, Uma. Yeah.
That is one way in which you arrived at this conclusion. Now, let us see whether anybody has a different point of view or if anybody else has noticed something
different.
Yeah.
Namaste, ma'am.
नमस्ते
यस गायत्री आचार्य मैम टीचर जो अध्यापिका जो है वो पढ़ा रहे हैं और पढ़ाने के साथ ही वो उनके साथ बैठ रहे हैं नीचे तो ये शायद बच्चों को अच्छा लगेगा पहले वो कुछ पिक्चर दिखा रहे हैं फिर पिक्चर दिखा के पहचान करके उस अक्षर को बता रहे हैं फिर वो उन्हीं के साथ बैठ के फिर पढ़ा रहे हैं तो बच्चों को लगेगा जैसे एज ए फ्रेंड मित्र है हमारे साथ बैठे हैं पढ़ाने वाले तो वो उनके साथ शायद उनका आंसर वो आसानी से दे और अच्छे से समझ सके
गायत्री बोल रहे
जी हाँ जी
आप थोड़ा सा मुझे बता पाएंगे कि इधर का जो पढ़ाने का जो अभी तक जो हमको समझ में आया ये उद्दिष्ट बोलते हैं उसको या पर्पस
यस
हाँ ये क्या है आपके आपको क्या लगता है कि क्या किस पर्पस से ये पढ़ा रहे हैं जो भी हमने तो छोटा सा क्लिप देखा लेकिन उसमें से भी आपको क्या
सॉरी
व्हाट डू यू फील इज द लेसन ऑब्जेक्टिव इन सो फार एज व्हाटएवर यू हैव ऑब्जर्व्ड आपने अभी तक जो देखा
जी
के मुताबिक आपको क्या लगता है कि क्या लेसन का ऑब्जेक्टिव क्या है
इसका उद्देश्य क्या है?
उद्देश्य यही है मैम कि वो जो बताना चाहते हैं, वो जो पढ़ाना चाहते हैं, या उन्होंने शायद कुछ पिक्चर्स बनाए थे ब्लैक बोर्ड पर, वो क्लियर नहीं थे, तो वो पिक्चर्स वो बताना चाहते थे कि हाँ ये पिक्चर्स हो सकता है वो अक्षर का नाम है या किस अक्षर से शुरू हो रहे हैं, वो बताना चाहते हैं, वो बच्चों ने सीखा। तो वो जो पिक्चर्स बता रहे थे, एक एक पिक्चर्स वो बना रहे थे और शायद वो पूछ रहे थे बच्चों को, बच्चे उनके आंसर दे रहे थे। वो वॉइस क्लियर नहीं था क्या आंसर दे रहे थे, पर मुझे शायद ये समझ में आया कि वो जो आंसर दे रहे या वो जो बताना चाहते थे वो बच्चे समझ गए, और दूसरा उनके साथ बैठ के फिर वो उन्हीं से पूछ रहे हैं, फिर उसके बाद उन्होंने पुस्तक उठाई।
ठीक है, तो आई थिंक गायत्री आपने बहुत अच्छा एक ऑब्जर्वेशन हमको दिया कि आपने जी बच्चों के साथ बैठी है, उससे आपको लगता है कि बच्चों के साथ एक नाता या यू नो एक रिलेशनशिप बनाने में थोड़ी सी मदद मिलती है।
जी जी जी,
खुलापन होता है आपको क्लास में।
थैंक यू,
थैंक यू। चैट बॉक्स
ज़ैनब माला, वुड यू लाइक टू स्पीक?
यस मैम, आई वुड लाइक टू ऐड टू दिस। Am I audible?
Yes.
Yeah. So I felt it was a traditional class because teacher's talk time was more than the children's talk time.
Okay.
And the seating arrangement of that rows and columns. The teacher was trying to show something in the textbook, but I wonder whether the students in the last row could see what she was trying to show. So if it would be in a semicircular form or something, it would be visible to all.
Okay. So what one of the statements, very nice, Zainab, you know, you have noticed a little more detail. So you felt that not all the students were actually able to see what she was showing.
See in the textbook, right. So if I would be in her place, I would have made flashcards and given to every student and let them interact and talk about what they have received in the flashcard.
Correct. So let's for the moment just keep aside the flashcard and let's move ahead, Zainab. And you know, you said that not everybody was able to see, right? Aisa matlab ek impression humko hua. So is the seating arrangement a reflection of whether a classroom is traditional or not?
Yeah, absolutely. Because mostly it always teachers feel it should be in rows and columns.
But Zainab, what my question to you would be then, and I think someone right at the beginning pointed out that this is an example where there are only 8-9 children, right? So can we then, is the corollary of this that in a classroom where there are 60 children, which is often the case in even a BMC school or many other schools, right, the teacher oftentimes has no choice but to make the because itna jagah hi nahi hota ki wo benches wagera aap move kare. So kya hum fir aisa kahein jab टीचर्स गोलाकार में बच्चों को नहीं बिठा सकती है तो वो ट्रेडिशनल क्लासरूम हो गया? इज दैट एन इंफरेंस यू कुड मेक बेस्ड ऑन व्हाट यू हैव जस्ट शेयर्ड? और आर देयर अदर वेज टू लुक एट वेदर समथिंग इज ट्रेडिशनल और नॉट? बिकॉज इट्स अ रियलिटी ऑफ आवर इंडियन क्लासरूम्स कि हमारे पास बच्चों को सीटिंग अरेंजमेंट बदलने का इतना अपॉर्चुनिटी फ्लेक्सिबिलिटी होता ही नहीं है. Even if the teacher is very motivated, very very dedicated and all that, वो बहुत मुश्किल है ऐसा करना. तो इस क्या हम फिर हम क्या कर सकते हैं? क्या वो क्लासरूम ट्रेडिशनल से नॉन ट्रेडिशनल बन सकता है? Okay, here Shikha is saying the teacher led is traditional. Seating Roshna Joseph is saying the seating arrangement helps interaction. Yes, of course. But what are some of the ways we can explore to promote teacher and student interaction?
Uma, can I speak? This is Philomena here.
Yes, Philomena.
Yeah. So I could sort of make out that this is more of a cooperative learning that was happening.
Philomena, what were the children learning? I think Ruchi, you might have to mute and unmute again.
No, it's okay. Sometimes people unmute by mistake. I have muted them. Sometimes it takes a little bit of time to find who is unmuted.
So let's listen to what Philomena has to
yes.
say.
Yes, Philomena, can you repeat, please?
Yes, so what I was trying to understand is that the teacher was trying to elicit responses from the children. It was more of cooperative learning that was happening is what I observed. But then I was just having this kind of thought that could we call this as inclusive? Could we call this as inclusive? Was the teacher able to reach out to 9 children in the classroom or 10 children in the classroom? And was she able to reach out to every learner?
Right.
Is the question that came to my mind, you know?
Philomena, even before we look at whether the teacher was able to reach every child,
right.
I hear from you, what do you think the children were learning? What was the learning happening? We are looking at learning classrooms, right? So what was the what are the students learning? In that little 5-minute clip, what did a child learn? Well, what was happening? I mean, forget the very beginning, but we know when she began with the textbook.
Yes.
What was yes. the children learning?
See, the topic that was given over there about festivals,
right.
she was very well connecting it one to the other, you know?
Okay. In what way could you explain? I mean, do you remember what she was saying? She was holding up a textbook.
Correct.
And then she was showing a picture?
Yes.
Then what was she doing when she showed up the picture?
I think she was asking questions.
Correct. What sort of questions were these?
Now, these questions were related to the festival.
Okay, of course. I mean, she was talking
about
what were the nature of the question?
What kind of response is expected? What was the nature of the question itself?
No, I really would not be able to tell you very clearly, you know.
It's also because it may have been in Marathi and it was shaky a little bit.
No. I'm well-versed with Marathi. So, mala problem kahits nahi hai Marathi. But I'm just trying to, you know, get to the crux of it. But if you don't mind, I would just like to know the answer to this.
Okay.
To whatever you asked me.
See, I think both Uma and myself, what we are trying to do is to generate discussion on
it.
Can I throw some light on this? I'm Nilima. Can I throw some light on this?
Yes,
Uma, up to you. Yeah.
Yeah.
I'm sorry to interrupt in between. First, I could not understand the video properly because at my end, that point of time, connection was very weak. But whatever I observed that the teacher is using questioning skills to promote thinking in students and she wants the response from students. So this is very good thing for the teacher to promote thinking and, you know, to teach them to respond, to be observant about the question. So I felt that part was very much valid in that video. And that really helps in teaching learning process in the class. That is one thing I wanted to just add on this discussion.
So Nilima, thank you for sharing what you said. I think, Ruchi, maybe we should move ahead a little.
Yes, we should. I just wanted to remind you, there are several chats which are saying closed questions, not thinking questions, guiding questions, the kind about the question that you had asked. I think we should move ahead now. And also just to remind everyone, it's not that Uma or myself, we are trying to arrive at the right answer. This is a platform for us to generate discussion on these points. And each of us may be having different perspectives of looking at the same thing. You remember the elephant story, right? It is like that we are looking at different parts of the elephant and we are interpreting it in different ways. But yes, we will discuss more on this issue going forward. Uma, back to you.
Yes. Very quickly, I'll share a little bit of what I observed. Right. Each time I observe this video, and probably I've used this video, I would say about 500 webinars over the last pandemic. We've used this video, and as many times as we've used this video, that
54.
So, if you notice, when the video began, right, where was the teacher standing? You know, you could pay your attention to, you know, bring your mind to some of those things. Where was the teacher standing? Where was the book placed, right? It gives you a chance to look at that. Where was the book placed? What is actually the lesson objective here? What is the teacher trying to do, right? Right at the very beginning, like someone probably in the chat said, it was a set induction. Yes, here Sangeeta says it was more like a picture talk, but that pic was shown by the teacher was too small for the... So now we see that Sangeeta has shown another level of noticing. Sangeeta has gone a little bit more and she's actually been able to say that, oh, my picture which I'm seeing in that video is very small. So as we look at the video, we start getting more and more specific in our noticing. So for example, I'll note down what I noticed right now. She asked the students three times. Three times she asked them, she said, aaj apan kay shiknar ahot? Diwali. Aaj apan kay shiknar ahot? Diwali. Aaj apan kay shiknar ahot? Diwali. She said it three times. Okay. So I have noted it down. So when you note down the number of times, it is known as coding. Okay. Coding is a technique that is used during video observation, right? So a lot of times when teachers say that the participation was very good, or you as observers might say, and there's certainly some very nice things in this classroom. So we are not trying to sort of deconstruct the, you know, whether the teacher is good or bad. We are trying to determine here whether the classroom is a learning classroom. A shikta varga ahe ka nahi? Is classroom mein bacche seekh rahe hain ya nahi? Aur agar seekh rahe hain to kya objective hai? Objective kya hai? Kya seekhne wale hain? Right? To idhar mere ko chat box mein kisi ne likha hai ki it seems like picture talk. Right? Ab agar hum soche ki picture talk hai, to picture talk ka uddishta kya hai? What is the lesson objective? Right? So I observed that the teacher was showing a picture. She was saying, idhar kya hai? Idhar kya hai aapko dikh raha hai? Idhar aapko toran dikh raha hai. Idhar kya dikh raha hai? Idhar aapko diva dikh raha hai. Kya dikh raha hai? Diva. Diva dikh raha hai. Okay? So what were the students doing? They were observing a picture. They were identifying and spotting. Okay? So the picture talk at this stage was at the level of spotting. Right? Identifying. I'm identifying what I'm seeing here. Right? Maybe this is the start of the lesson and maybe she moves it ahead a little bit. But what I noticed at the beginning was that the teacher was actually getting the children to identify. Right? Now these are, I think, second and third standard students. And probably they have already crossed the level where they can identify a picture. Aapko pata hai ki jab bacche pehli dusri mein aate hain, tab hum shayad unko poochte hain ki ye kiska picture hai, ye iska picture hai, ye kiska picture hai. But now the children have moved to one level. So one of the things which we observed was that could the teacher have increased the complexity of this lesson even for picture reading, right? And I think kisi ne aur ne bataya ki ye information ka lesson hai. So before we quickly move on, Ruchi, I just want any one person to sort of tell me what they think is the lesson objective. Is lesson ke end mein bachcho ko kya aana chahiye? What okay. No, I mean, of course, you'll have to watch the whole video and it's an 11-minute.
Shalini Mukun, would you like to speak?
Yeah, actually, for me, the language is a little difficult because I don't understand Marathi. But going by the previous discussions, I just wanted to share one or two points on that. Even in a traditional classroom, I agree with Ms. Uma when she's saying the complexity of the questions could have been better. Her instructions were very good. Voice was loud and clear. And within the limited resources that she had, I think she tried to do her best, catering to the children's needs.
We are not asking an opinion-based question. I'm glad you're doing. Okay, so one of the things we have to stay away from is good, bad, I think this, I think that. No, what did you see? When you say something is
good, that is a little difficult because I don't follow the language. Yeah, I'll have to see the video
Let's give a chance to someone else who can speak about what was the objective of the lesson.
What is the objective of the lesson? Iske end mein bachcho ko kya aana chahiye?
Excuse me, ma'am.
Hello, ma'am.
Ma'am, Gayatri.
Yes.
Gayatri.
Spoken. Can we have someone else speak?
Ishani. Ishani, can you speak? Yes.
Yeah. Yes, ma'am.
You're on mute.
Oops. Ishani, please unmute. I think I muted you by mistake.
As you have explained, I don't understand Marathi. So, as you explained from that, means I got that it is like to identify the things that are been used during this festival and to relate that festival with like which particular festival it is.
So, Ishani, is the objective of a language learning class to understand and know about festivals?
Yes.
Is that the objective of the language learning class? Is that how you would say it? What according to you, agar aapko ek sentence mein bolna hoga, if you had to frame it in one sentence, what is the
identifying the things.
Identification.
Okay. Yes, identifying.
All right. So, identifying objects shown in a picture is... So, if this is the objective, do you think the objective was achieved?
Students were answering. In that way, they are means identifying the things. So, she is also telling them with the, showing the picture that this is Toran, as you told, that this is Toran, this is Diya. So, to helping them to identify. She is helping them to identify. And they are now...
Who was deciding which who was deciding which spot to look at? Who was deciding?
Teacher only is showing and...
Teacher is pointing. She's pointing at the top, she's pointing at the left, she's pointing.
Yes. Yes, sir. Yes, ma'am.
So let us see if anybody has any other lesson of this, otherwise we'll move ahead a little bit.
Someone has responded listening skills as the objective.
Listening. Okay, so could that person actually speak as to why they feel building listening skills is the objective? And how do you think it was achieved? So it's a little bit of short play, but nevertheless, if you... Yeah, Nitya Potan is saying close-ended questions, lower-ended self-response questions. More of a picture talk, a picture shown by the teacher.
Ma'am, may I speak? I'm Sangeeta here. May I speak?
Sure.
I was welcome. Yeah, for me, it was a picture talk, but as you said, that it was teacher-directed rather than involving the children. It should have been more an inquiry based as to test the knowledge of these children who have some knowledge about the festival of Diwali, which is a very common festival in India.
But so, why would you feel that the objective of a language learning classroom is to be a social lesson? Sangeeta, are you speaking?
Sangeeta, can you please unmute?
Yeah, am I audible, ma'am?
Yes, you are.
Yeah. See, when you relate children to something which is very known to them, it encourages them and gives them an opportunity to speak. Ideally, the children should be more participative in this kind of lessons because I teach very lower grade, primary and pre-primary children, and we usually have a lot of response in language development from the child's side through these kind of activities in language, you know.
So, Sangeeta, could you share in what kind of language?
Ma'am, there is some disturbance. I'm not able to get your question, ma'am.
I was asking that.
So, Hani, please mute.
Yes, ma'am.
There is language development happening, right?
Mm-hmm. Yes, ma'am.
How will you determine whether the child's language has been developed even in these 5-6 minutes?
I mean, the child is hearing new language, maybe new words which is added to his vocabulary.
Did you really feel that there was any vocabulary? Could you notice anything in those 5 minutes of any new vocabulary words that had come up?
She was relating to things related to Diwali, like Toran and Diva, and so how much ever I have knowledge about Marathi. So, of course, Not much, but it could have been a much more interactive. As you said, everything was pointed by the teacher rather than asking the child, do you recognize this? You know, hey, kaya, hey, manje, you can ask the child, you know, do you see, what do you see in a picture? Like that is, we ask, it's more of a probing.
So we'll I think, Ruchi, let's move ahead. What we'll do is, because there is a lot of discussion that is coming, I won't continue this video. I'll show another video.
Yeah, that is a good idea.
And then we'll get a video and then we will sort of bring it together.
आमच्या शाळेत अनेक मराठी भाषक मुलं येतात. त्यांना संवादाची शिक्षणाची भाषा म्हणून मराठी शिकवणं हे एक आव्हान असतं. त्याचवेळी त्यांना त्यांच्या मातृभाषेविषयी दुरावा न्यूनगंड वाटू न देणं हे सुद्धा आवश्यक असतं. एका भाषेकडून दुसऱ्या भाषेकडे होणारा हा प्रवास आनंददायी भाषा समृद्ध करणारा हवा. यासाठी आम्ही चर्चा चित्र वाचन संभाषण याद्वारे असे अनुभव संधी जाणीवपूर्वक शालेय वातावरणात निर्माण करतो.
आज आपण तुम्हीच काढलेली चित्र आहेत की नाही त्या चित्रांवर सगळ्यांनी गप्पा मारायचं. चित्र के ऊपर चित्र देखेंगे फिर बाद में उसमें जो क्या है वो आप अपने मित्र को बताओगे और वो तुम्हें बताएं. अभी मैं सबको एक एक चित्र देती हूँ. बोलो ना बोलो
ऐसे टोपी पहनती है मस्जिद में नमाज पढ़ने जाते हैं सबको ईद मुबारक देते हैं.
भाषा शिक्षणामध्ये मुलांची चर्चा हे एक उत्तम साधन आहे आणि हे नेहमीच मी माझ्या वर्गामध्ये वापरत असते. मुलं चांगल्या प्रकारे व्यक्त होत असतात म्हणूनच आज मी चित्रावर आधारित चर्चा मुलांमध्ये घडविली आणि याच्यामध्ये मुलं भोजपुरी मराठी हिंदी या भाषांमध्ये आणि ह्या भाषा एकत्र करून सुद्धा मिश्र भाषेत चर्चा करत होती आणि ह्या चर्चा योग्य होण्यासाठी मी त्यांना हिंदी आणि मराठीमध्ये सूचना दिल्या.
गाँव में भी डांस करते हैं मेरे गाँव में और होली खेलते हैं मेरे गाँव में रंग गीत कर रंग उड़ते हैं मेरे गाँव में खीर बनता है.
हमारे घर क्रिसमस का दिन आया तो हम पूरा घर सजाते हैं. तुम्हारे पापा माँ सजाते हैं?
हम पापा माँ हम सजाते सब कुछ सजाते
भाषेच्या वर्गात आमच्या शाळेतील बोलतकांचा खूपच चांगला उपयोग होतो. बोलफलकावर वाक्य लिहिल्याने आपले अनुभव इतरांना सांगण्याची संधी मिळते आणि आलेले अनुभव जोडी जोडीने बोलफलकावर मांडता व व्यक्त करता येतात. सगळे जण आपल्या आपल्या जागेवर यायचंय. अभी जो हमने फलक पे जो लिखा है एक एक वाक्य पढेंगे और अलग तरीके से भी लिखेंगे. ओंकारचं वाक्य आपण वाचणार आहोत. ओंकार का वाक्य हम पढेंगे पहिले. गुढी पाडवा हा सण मला खूप आवडतो. ओंकार के घर पे अगर सण बोलते है तो उसने बराबर लिखा है. ओंकार ये वाक्य और भी अलग तरीके से लिख सकते है कि गुढी पाडवा हा क्या लिखेंगे. क्या लिखेंगे सृष्टि. सण. न को अलग तरीके से भी लिख सकते है. गुढी पाडवा हा सण मला आवडतो. चलो आवडतो. आवडते लिखे लिखा है वो आवडतो लिखेंगे. कंचन का हम देखेंगे. देखो उसने हिंदी में लिखने का प्रयास किया. उसको हिंदी आता है तो हिंदी में लिखा है. हम लोग इसको मराठी में भी कर सकते हैं. मुझे स्कूल पसंद है भाई. हिंदी में क्या लिखना चाहिए ना. मुझे स्कूल पसंद है. लेकिन वो बोलती है वैसा उसने लिखा है कि मुझे स्कूल पसंद है. ये भी बराबर है. ये मराठी में हम कैसे बोल सकते हैं बता. खड़ी खूब छाया आवड़ो. अभी इसको और भी अच्छे तरीके से कर सकते हैं हम. अल्ताफ अल्ताफ बता.
माला शाला खूब आवड़ती.
माला शाला खूब आवड़ती. बोल फलकावर लिहिलेली वाक्य विद्यार्थी आपल्या मित्रमैत्रिणींच्या सहभागाने आणि माझ्याही सहभागाने लिहित असतात आणि योग्य प्रकारे करत असतात. त्याच्यामुळे त्यांना कोणत्याही प्रकारच्या कमीपणाची जाणीव होते. रोशनिका देखो. रोशनिका देखते हैं हम. रोशनी ने भोजपुरी भाषा में जो वाक्य है भोजपुरी में जो करते हैं उसके गांव में वो लिखा है. रोशनी को पढ़ के दिखाओगी क्या लिखा है तुमने.
हाय लईकिनिया छुरछुरी बजावतिया.
हाय लईकिनिया छुरछुरी बजावतिया. हाँ उसका वाक्य मराठी में भी उसने लिखा है. देखो भोजपुरी में भी लिखा है और उसका वाक्य मराठी में भी लिखा है. क्या लिखा है. रोशनी पढ़ो जोर से.
वेरी
गुड. ही मुलगी सुरसुरी बाजवत आहे. मला असं वाटतं शाळेत आलेलं प्रत्येक मूल हे महत्वाचं असतं आणि त्यांना व्यवहारात उपयोगी असं शिक्षण मिळणं गरजेचं असतं. म्हणूनच या दृष्टिकोनातून वर्गात वातावरण निर्मिती केल्याने मुलं एकमेकांच्या सहभागाने आणि समानतेच्या भावनेने भाषा शिकतात. याचमुळे अगदी नवीन दाखल झालेलं मूल सुद्धा मराठी भाषा चांगल्या प्रकारे आत्मसात करतो. हा अनुभव मला आला.
रुची, वॉज इट ऑडिबल?
Yes, yes, it was completely audible and even I could follow everything because of the transcript being there in English. And I can understand Marathi also to quite an extent. But I hope even others were able to follow this. It was really nice. I mean, I felt like really clapping out of joy because it was such a nice classroom in which not only students from different languages, different cultures, different kinds of festivals, all was accepted. And it was such a nice diversity which was visible in the classroom. But let's also hear from others.
So what, again, now as you're going to respond from the point of view of what you felt that the students were doing, what exactly did you feel the teacher was doing, what was the lesson objective, if you could comment a little bit upon the classroom environment, you know, all of these things would be useful to take the discussion forward. I think a lot of people would, Ruchi, like you, give comments on what they liked. And that's wonderful.
Yes.
What we would also like is to have a little bit discussion on what did you notice? Aapne dekha kya?
Exactly.
Kya dekha aapne?
So, Should I read from the comments? They're coming quite fast. Freedom of expression, students given freedom to speak their views. I think there were earlier.
We have Roshna Joseph, I can see. She's raised her hand.
Yeah. Zenobia also has been raising hand to speak. Yeah. So whom do you can call people whom you want to.
Zenobia, would you like to unmute yourself and speak, please?
Good afternoon, everyone. What I noticed between the first video and the second video was that while the lesson was going on in the first class, there were too many charts and everything which were distracting, which could distract a specially abled child.
All right.
Whereas over here, there were, the children's focus was more at their eye level on the blackboard kind of thing, which was spread all across the room. So they were focused on writing. So that was one element that came to my notice. And I was going to raise that in the previous question also, as to how advisable is it to stimulate children with too many charts in the classroom, because then the distraction level for specially able children is a little difficult.
Right. So Zenobia, I wouldn't be able to comment on, you know, whether or not one should use, but I know the reality of classrooms in rural India is such that oftentimes the walls are painted. Okay.
Right.
So the teachers don't have a flexibility on whether or not they can remove it or not. So
right.
On one spectrum, we see this. On the other hand, we also see, even in municipal schools and all that, that the material that is displayed on the walls is there for years to come.
Years to come, correct.
Things will come. Right? So if you were to ask me, what really should the material be about? It should be reflective of student learning, right? It's not going to be possible for every classroom to have these kind of blackboards, and certainly not in city schools at all, right? However, how can we use the classroom space effectively to display student learning? Right, and you might be familiar with the term making student learning visible, making student thinking visible, right? So a learning classroom is one where the teacher is able to creatively use space to make the student learning visible. It might be a special child, might have just do something, right?
Mm-hmm.
But if you display that on the wall, that is a far better use of space than going one extreme where you have everything painted and you have those charts put up.
Correct.
The other end where there is an overload of stimulation, as you're saying, what if I was a teacher, what I would look to do is to actually have the student learning up front, because obviously every child feels that pride, you know, my stuff is out. I mean, I remember from my own childhood, if the teacher put up my chart, I mean, I felt like top of the world. So, you know, so how much space?
So, I think to that extent, this blackboard thing where the children were allowed to write did achieve the purpose, because they were able to come forward, they were able to see, and they were able to write, take pride in whatever they wrote. So
yes,
that identification was to some extent there.
Right. And one of the things from experiences I know we have seen is that a lot of classrooms where there is a lack of space, such as the one here there was, they put, and I think a lot of teachers here would know, you put a lot of strings and you put them across class, across windows, and you have things hanging. Right. So that is also another way in which then we've had classrooms where we've seen exit tickets, as you call. So part of the classrooms, you know, the if you shut the door and the behind, what is put up on behind, there is a broom and there is a supri. Actually, that is put because that's how the classrooms are to be cleaned. Right. So we've had discussions with teacher that could we find another spot for this? And maybe at the end of that, we have the students get out of the class and put a smiley, right? How did I feel today? Did I enjoy the class? Just a smile or a, you know, just draw like that. So some teachers did that. So how you use space is something you can notice when you're using videos as a tool for deconstruction. So ye jagah ka use kaise kiya gaya hai, ye aapko tab realize hoga jab aap koi video leke aayenge aur wo video mein dekhenge ki wo jagah kaise use ho raha hai. So it's just helpful. And it's a dimension that needs to be noticed. So in the first video we saw, somebody said ki maine dekha ki bacche ek ke piche ek baithe hain, and somebody in the chat box also said ki kyun na wo goal baithe. So seating arrangement, right?
It's a difference.
So use of space means seating arrangement. Use of physical space is also something that one has to notice to sort of evaluate and to reflect upon whether it's a learning classroom.
Hmm.
So I don't know if I've answered your question, but
yes, yes, thank you. I mean, I just, this was my observation, which I felt I needed to just give.
Yeah.
Thank you.
Can I please come in over here, if sure. I may?
Yeah.
Yeah, hi, I'm Vaishali, and I actually work in the field of drama and education as a pedagogy. So I saw a lot of that being used in this classroom. First of all, what I saw was that there were no chairs, which was amazing. I mean, I think this was the first thing that I noticed, that there were no chairs in the classroom. The second, what Zenobia rightly noticed, is the blackboard across the room at the height of the child. That kind of was really, really good. I mean, I think that was very well planned and thought. The other thing that I noticed about the teacher was that the teacher was almost like a performer. And she was trying to make an eye contact with every child, which was amazing, so that the child could really take in from whatever the teacher was saying. Second, she used pair and peer learning, which was again, which would kind of initiate conversations first. The first idea behind, language learning is to start talking. So that was amazing that they would discuss and exchange information. And then the whole idea of including different dialects was amazing. And the way she moved from, how Hindi is similar to Marathi, and looking at the similarities and how, everything is simple, and she made it very simple for the children. It was not that they had to learn something, she was playing with them, and that's what I noticed.
What do you think Vaishali contributed to the talk? You're right that there was a lot of student talk, and specifically in the form of peer talk, right?
Yes.
So
yes.
What were some of the things that she did as a teacher which you noticed have promoted peer talk? Perhaps the seating arrangement could be one.
Yes.
What are some of the other things you think have
the visual stimulus and the pictures that she shared.
Talk about the pictures.
And about the pictures, I would say they were all handmade by the children themselves. That was amazing. I mean, I think getting handmade drawings by children makes so much more of a deeper impact in the child, because probably they're watching their own painting that they have made, or their friends, which makes them feel included in the learning process as well.
So Vaishali, just to move this a little bit forward, you made a statement that I think that the handmade drawings helped the classroom to move forward and helped to promote student talk, right?
Yes.
Do you think that we could go one step forward and say that when we are doing picture talk, the use of the children's own pictures helps, I think Nilima or someone else had also said that, we're trying to build vocabulary, or we're trying to build, trying to develop their language. So certainly having pictures which the child brings are useful. But I would go one step further. You are saying that hand-drawn, okay?
Yes.
It's possible for a child to actually bring a picture of a photo that is lying in his house. It's not hand-drawn. It's a picture that I've got from my house of my grandmother or something like that, right?
Yes.
It's not necessary that the picture needs to be hand-drawn. The opportunity for a child to bring...
To bring something of his own or her own.
So what you call is realia in teaching. Probably you've heard the term.
Yeah, no, I didn't hear that term. Thank you. Yes. Yeah.
So the realia plays a far more important role than whether it is hand-drawn or not. But certainly in this class it has helped. And, that you've noticed is great. Let's see if anyone else has noticed anything else.
Ma'am, one more point I would like to add here. The thing is, Vaishali ma'am actually and Zenobia ma'am, both of them, they covered most of the points. But one thing I felt was it was beyond the picture. The children actually, they shared their experiences. The girl said that how it is, what do you do? My house is decorated. What do you all do? So I think they went beyond the picture. They could actually express themselves. They were very much involved in what they were doing. It was not limited to picture talk. It was more than that. And that connect is what was met by the teacher. So that was beautiful.
Absolutely. So it really did go beyond identifying or spotting. I think somebody in the chat box had said that certainly the complexity could be improved. Because oftentimes when we think of picture talk, we only think of the identification. But is the language learning outcome identification? Perhaps at a very young age, it might be just spotting, you know, what this means.
Also appreciation. The teacher brought out the beauty of every language. Children were patiently observing each other. They were looking at the uniqueness that every language brought along with it. The other children were trying to help out the person to translate the same thing in Marathi, probably a better vocabulary to be used. Errors were spotted then and there. They were not errors. They were just that the child expressed it that way. What would be a better way to express the same? So then and there, when things are rectified, I think they get it better. And they would not make those errors in future. They will express it more beautifully. Probably they've learned it through their peers. And those aspects were very vital, I felt, in learning. Because rather than putting a tick mark and a red, using a pen to correct it or zero it on, here the children were just learning and grasping it. And when their own peers are telling them, they find it more acceptable and they try to adopt it easily.
Surely.
Ma'am, I would like to show.
This type increases the confidence in the children. The way they kept on interacting, everybody was reinforcing the other one, encouraging the other one. And so the lot of self-confidence was developed within them.
So, but I have another question to ask, that in both the videos, we see the use of pictures, right?
Yeah.
Promote language development. Whatever way, in the earlier video, the teacher was trying. Why do we feel that in the second video, what might have contributed to the teacher actually using a different pictures made by students?
Ma'am, actually, these pictures made by students, they encourage you more. They give you more confidence. Ki dekha, meri picture dekhi gayi hai. Like, you know, it is mine. You know, I made it. You know, that confidence instantly boosts you up. And wo jo chote bacche ka tha, that scenario was different.
Can I add it here? Children. Can I add in to what Shalini is telling right now? Can I?
Yeah.
Sorry to intervene, Shalini.
No, ma'am.
I just want to tell, I just want to add on to what Shalini is telling. Actually, the first video which you have shown was like very formal, you know, kind of a setup. The traditional one, which, you know, most of my friends are telling here. Wherein the class is like a typical classroom. Mostly children at a very young age, say for example, class 1 to class 8 to tak. Okay, they want something very free. They want to be free and, you know, they want to open up, share up. And that kind of a situation was provided in the second video where, you know, the children were able to express. So that freedom without any constraint, you can just give out whatever you have or whatever your talent is what made the class more joyful. That is what I felt.
What contributes to this freedom? Why? What do you think is the reason there was freedom in the second classroom and not in the first classroom?
Because the first classroom, I couldn't understand the language, first of all. Sorry, I'm from down south. I don't know this. The second thing.
Freedom to come dikh raha
tha, na? Freedom come dikh raha tha. The reason why freedom...
Actually, it's the main thing, ma'am. When they are very small, they are able to express, but not so much. And the teacher has to make them follow her way, you know. It is how you start teaching. But as they grow up, then they know how to respond, how to say things for themselves. And then the teacher can lead the students way.
Okay. I think at both levels, it is possible for students to respond. Go ahead, Uma. Yeah.
This is very interesting. So you might...
Ma'am, should I
wait for Uma to respond and then come in, please? Yeah. Uma, go ahead. Yeah.
Very interesting that we have a sort of a belief or a thinking that when very young children are there, they need to be guided, right? Okay, so we need to examine, is this really needed? Or is it really something that I'm holding on because this is something I have learned, right? So in both the classrooms, even in the first classroom, the teacher had the freedom to use a different picture, right? The teacher could have used a different picture, right? But why did she not use a different picture? Because aisa maine socha hi nahi. Mere ko to syllabus complete karna hai. Mera ye textbook hai, ye chapter hai, mujhe ye aisa hi padhana hai. Right? So there is no question of my getting another picture. Because abhi mere ko ye picture ke end mein jo question answer hai, wo bachche ko aana chahiye. Aur wo bachcha agar question answer karega, to mera language learning outcome achieve ho gaya hai. Right? So is the teacher learning anything about the child? About how the child is thinking? Right? Is the teacher asking questions that makes the child think? I'll give you an example of how the same thing was done in another classroom in Pune. The children, you know, this is very simple. तुम किसी भी बच्चे को चार pictures पकड़ा दो, वो बता देंगे ये दिया है, ये है, ये फटाफट in few minutes the children will say all of this. The challenge that was given to the students was to encourage peer talk. कि अगर आपको देखो दिवाली के टाइम तो इतना पोल्यूशन होता है, आप सबको ही मालूम है कि वो सुरसुरी फटाका ये सब सबको अच्छा लगता है बजाना. तो सो देन द टीचर आज एंड वाई डू यू लाइक टू सेल यू नो डू ऑल ऑफ दिस. सो द चिल्ड्रन सेड कि बहुत मजा आता है, वो बूम करके आवाज आता है ना, बहुत मजा आता है, राइट. सो देन द टीचर सेड ओके, सो नाउ वी आर ऑल गोइंग टू थिंक ऑफ अ वे टू सेलिब्रेट दिस फेस्टिवल एंड वी आर गोइंग टू एंजॉय द साउंड ऑल्सो, बट वी आर नॉट गोइंग टू हैव क्रैकर्स because they cause pollution. So I want everybody to group in pairs and come up with a way in which we are all going to celebrate Diwali without bursting crackers, but we are going to enjoy the sound, right? Because wo boom boom sound aata hai, usse humko maza aata hai. Then small children. So these are very young children, okay? They got together and they came up with this idea ki hum na ek band bajayenge. We'll form a band, actually. Aur hum drum bajayenge. And somebody said we will do this. और वो दिवाली के शाम पे ना हम ऐसे अपने घर के बाहर ना जोर जोर से वो करेंगे. मे बी इन कोरोना तो हमने खाली बजाई है, बट दिस इज व्हाट द स्टूडेंट सेड, राइट. सो कैन यू इमेजिन द काइंड ऑफ टॉक दिस जनरेटेड इन द क्लासरूम. सो द एस्पेक्ट ऑफ गेटिंग द चिल्ड्रन टू आइडेंटिफाई ऑब्जेक्ट्स इन अ पिक्चर द टीचर डिड इन 3 minutes एंड द रेस्ट ऑफ द 35 minutes वाज स्पेंट इन दिस गेटिंग द चिल्ड्रन टू थिंक एंड इट वाज सच एन इंटरेस्टिंग डिस्कशन एंड द चिल्ड्रन केम विद ऑल सॉर्ट्स ऑफ थिंग्स यू नो. Then who will be in the band? फिर band के लिए सामान कहाँ से आएगा? फिर आवाज कैसे आएगा? वो सुर में आएगा कि नहीं आएगा? So this was the kind of talk. And from that, you know, the talk generated a lot of sentences, a lot of words, which the teacher put down, right? But for a teacher to make such a shift in practice, it requires a lot of handholding and support. So as an organization, we have the deepest respect and empathy for teachers. क्योंकि ये कहना बहुत आसान है. कल को आपको कोई खड़ा कर देगा ना 50 बच्चों के सामने, देन यू विल नो व्हाट हाउ डिफिकल्ट इट इज. एंड आई एम श्योर ऑल द टीचर्स हियर आपको पता है, यू नो व्हाट इट इज लाइक. एंड वी हैव बीन इन बीएमसी स्कूल्स, इट्स सो हार्ड यू नो फॉर द टीचर्स टू टीच, इट्स एक्सट्रीमली डिफिकल्ट. सो इवन द टीचर इन द फर्स्ट सेशन इन द फर्स्ट वन, राइट, शी इज ऑल्सो फ्रॉम द सिस्टम, राइट. शी हैज समबडी हू इज कमिंग एंड वीडियोइंग हर एंड शी हैज समबडी हू इज गोइंग टू आस्क हर ये 3 महीने के बाद आपने वो चैप्टर कंप्लीट हुआ कि नहीं हुआ तो क्यों नहीं हुआ, राइट. सो इट्स वेरी वेरी हार्ड फॉर टीचर्स टू ब्रेक अवे फ्रॉम दिस एंड ट्राई एंड डू समथिंग डिफरेंट एंड ऑल ऑफ दिस. बट एज समबडी हू इज लुकिंग एट योर ओन प्रैक्टिस और इफ यू आर अ कोच एंड यू आर गोइंग टू लुक एट अ टीचर्स प्रैक्टिस, यू हैव टू स्टार्ट विद वेयर द टीचर इज. तो अगर इस टीचर के साथ हम काम करते तो हम टीचर्स को ये नहीं बोलते कि आपने ऐसा करना चाहिए. आपको क्या लगता है कि इसमें हम क्या फर्क कर सकते हैं? आपको क्या लगता है? Okay, then if the teacher says ki haan main inko goal mein bhi bitha sakti thi, I could have made them sit like this, okay, then the teacher takes ownership for that change in teacher practice. Agar hum jaake bole ki aap aisa kariye to no teacher will do it, you know, because why are you telling me? I know my class, right? So it's very important for us as we use video observation as a tool to have a not only have a noticing framework but also have a very empathetic eye, you know. So when we do this is ki hum wo ek kahawat bolte hai na ki bahut lambi deal deni hoti hai, okay, to aap teachers ko bahut zyada lambi deal do, you know, and if you are a teacher yourself aap apne aap ko bhi deal do, right. Aur mere khayal aap sabko ye bhi pata hoga ki as teachers many times na sometimes you might have a great lesson in mind but that particular day the children behave very badly for some reason or the other, okay. तो मतलब मैंने तो सब कुछ प्रिपरेशन किया, मेरा लेसन प्लान था, टीचिंग लर्निंग मटेरियल था, क्लासरूम सीटिंग था, सब कुछ था, बट द लेसन इज अ मेस, ओके, एंड इट्स जस्ट अ बैड डे, ओके, एंड एवरीबडी हैज अ बैड डे, राइट. सो ऐसा भी होता है कई बार कि आपको अगर आपके प्रैक्टिस में बदलाव लाना है तो आप किसी एक वीडियो को देखे या एक लेसन को देख के डोंट अराइव एट अ कंक्लूजन, वॉच अ सीरीज ऑफ वीडियोज एंड देन यू विल नो वॉट योर पैटर्न इज ऑफ टीचिंग, राइट. So I think, Ruchi, we can take some other questions.
Yeah.
If required.
Yeah.
There's just one more observation, if I may.
Yeah.
The teacher in the first previous video was talking at the students, but in the next one, the teacher was talking to the children. So this is something that I noticed as well.
Yes. And also a lot of times Vaishali we notice that the teachers tend to be very repetitive. So मैंने शुरू में आपको बताया ना कि तीन बार वो टीचर ने बोला कि आपको तुम्हें बघितलं का आज आपण कुठलं करणार आहोत. They repeated 4-5 times. Now why does this repetition happen? Because I have not thought through कि मेरा आगे का sentence होना क्या है. तो जब तक मेरे दिमाग में वो नहीं आ रहा है what is my next sentence, I just keep repeating the first sentence 3-5 times, right? So that's why the teacher preparation is very, very critical. कि आप कितने तैयार हो, right?
Yeah, it could also be that the teacher thinks that the listening is an important part of that lesson, and the children will learn only through listening, and therefore repeats it 4 times to get students' attention completely so that they are listening to her. I mean, it could also be that. That's why she's repeating again and again, just to so that the attention is there, and then she can perhaps grow forward.
But look at it, Ruchi, that the teacher feels that if I repeat 5-10 times, that is the way to get attention of students.
Yeah, that itself is problematic. Yeah.
Can there be another way to retain students' attention without having to repeat the same thing 10 times?
Yeah.
Can I say something? Just add on to one more point.
Yes, sure.
Yeah. Most of the points that I thought of have been covered. In the end, I also felt that the teacher, the second video, she did an informal kind of assessment by allowing the children to write on the board.
Yes.
So her purpose is formative. Achieved.
Yeah.
Yeah.
It was a kind of a formative assessment.
Yeah, it was an assessment without the children actually understanding that, and they enjoyed the thing to the fullest. And also that in between where she does that sentence construction and all, you know, in a very, very, like as if it is a process in flow. Like some word the child had pronounced wrong. It was a Marathi word. I was not able to make out something like avarte. And she said, it's not the way you do. This is the correct way to pronounce. So functional grammar was given importance. And the assessment was done in such a beautiful way that it did not look like a scary thing to the students.
Right. Very true, Shalini. And one of the things, assessment is a part of a dimension that we need to observe. Is assessment happening only at the end of the lesson? Is it happening throughout the lesson? Because we've been told as teachers ki aapko formative assessment karna hai, lekin kab karna hai, kaise karna hai, how do you, okay? And these lessons of best practice, why are they useful? Aap soch lijiye ki agar aap kisi training workshop mein hai aur aapko koi aapko lecture de raha hai ki aisa acha class hota hai, okay, and you are just giving a lecture, nobody gets it, aapko samajh mein nahi aata hai. You need to have a example. अभी हमारे एनईपी पॉलिसी में भी ये बोला है कि 21st सेंचुरी स्किल्स क्रिटिकल थिंकिंग रीजनिंग, राइट? तो ये सारे बजवर्ड्स तो पता है, लेकिन क्रिटिकल थिंकिंग वाला क्लास दिखता कैसे है? आई गॉट टू सी इट टू बी एबल टू अंडरस्टैंड इट, एंड दैट्स व्हाई यू नो वीडियो बिकम्स अ वेरी पावरफुल टूल. आई मीन एटलीस्ट वी हैव फाउंड इट वेरी पावरफुल टू हेल्प टीचर्स टू चेंज देयर प्रैक्टिस. मतलब ना, एक तो मैं खुद अपना प्रैक्टिस चेंज करूंगी और मेरे को दिखता है अच्छा हाँ ऐसा. Now imagine if the teacher has not got any other visual aid to see this, then it's harder to visualize and conceptualize it. So
I think this is like something like in the higher classes, if they have to teach math and physics, which are scary subjects for many, even in the long run of life, then this kind of a teaching would really make it much easier, and the fear of the subjects would go away.
Yes. So I think, Ruchi, can we move ahead? Because there are 2 more sections I need to cover very quickly.
Yeah, I think,
Ruchi, ma'am, can I come in? Lois here.
I think we are really short of time because it's already 4:20. And I'll just give the space to Uma to go ahead with what she wanted to convey to us. We do have next week a sharing session based on this session itself. And you all can go ahead and speak and share your thoughts and ideas in that session itself. And so let us give time to Uma to say further. Yeah, go ahead.
I want to just share what we do, and
yeah,
you know, when we are helping teachers to become reflective. Are you able to see?
Yes, we can. Yes, we can.
So what you see in front of you is a noticing framework. So when you're looking at a classroom, and when you're observing what is happening in a classroom, this is a framework that we use for looking at whether it's a learning classroom. Now, what you see over here is purpose, or which is lesson objective. So this is one of the dimensions that you look at when you are sort of seeing whether the children are really learning. The second part you're looking at is student engagement. By student engagement, you not only look at what the children are doing, but whether they are engaged in tasks that are meaningful. They are engaged in activities that help them to make meaning. Meaning-making activities may involve hai ki nahi bache. Or are they only involved in activities where they are only doing answering? You know, yes, no answering, or, you know, just repetition and so on. So what is the nature of student engagement is critical here. Yahan pe aapko dikh raha hai curriculum and pedagogy. So here we are looking at what are the methods that the teacher is using to transact a particular lesson, to teach a particular concept. You know, what are the different sort of materials she has used? Is it aligned? Is the transaction of those activities aligned to the purpose? So we have, in our experience, we have seen ki teacher ka lesson objective kuch hota hai, jo activities hote hai, uska aur usse kuch lena dena nahi hota hai. They're not actually linked to each other. So is that linked or not? So these are some of the things that is looked at in this particular framework. Here you're looking at classroom environment and culture. So in classroom environment, we look at a couple of things. We look at what are classroom routines that are being used by teachers, right? And the routines contribute to making a culture. So for example, in certain classrooms, we have observed ki wo bacche aate hi, it's a very simple thing that children come and in a line, they hang the water bottles on the hooks, right? This is a classroom routine, right? There is a particular school we've seen where every morning, as soon, I think once a week, there is a routine. The children come in the morning and there are a set of dictionaries that are kept. And the children have to go spot a new word and you know, tell it to their peer, and then there is a wall in which they are going to go and put up that word. This is a routine that that particular, you know, school has done. So this is, in their minds, this is promoting a culture of learning. So when we talk about culture, we talk about routines that are transacted in a classroom. When we talk about environment, we talk about whether there is an environment of risk taking, there is an environment of collaboration, is there an environment where the children free to make mistakes. That's what we mean, you know, in environment. We also talk about physical seating, right? How is the seating conducive, or what is the use of space to help the learner learn better, or the students learn better? And the last point, which I think, you know, the last participant just said, is about assessment. So one of the things one looks at is, you know, has the teacher been able to assess throughout the lesson whether the children have learned or not, aligned to my purpose? So this is a noticing framework that we use. Now this noticing framework, if you wanted to know the details, is available on Center for Educational Leadership by University of Washington in Seattle. We have adapted it from there. So this is not something that we've sort of created on our own. And this has come about after a lot of research. So I think research was done across hundreds and thousands of schools to find out that what do instructional leaders really look at when they're looking in a classroom. And this is what, you know, after all that research that they did, they came up with this. Of course, there are other noticing frameworks also. It's not that this is the only one, but, you know.
Just to add to your point, for that classroom environment and culture, we have been having sessions, and we have been told, like, instead of taking attendance simply as yes ma'am, that rote method, you know, so you could come up with a nice English sentence, ki koi bhi ek sentence bolo English mein, to build up the vocabulary of the child. Because little children, they are just not confident in speaking. So that ghar mein wo mahol hi nahi hai English bolne ka. So jab wo school aate hain aur wo ek sentence English mein bolte hain, wo bhi with correct grammar. So that is, like, you know, how children are appreciated for that.
Absolutely. And I think every school, every teacher, every classroom has their unique routines. So isme kuch sahi, galat, right, wrong nahi hai. But typically children know. So for example, many of you know ki when you are absent as a teacher, wo classroom mein pura confusion ho jata hai, chaos ho jata hai, ya bachcho ko malum rehta hai ki jab jis din meri miss, mere sir absent rehne wale hai, what am I supposed to do when I enter the class? So does the classroom completely go into complete chaos, or is there a certain amount of confidence that the children have that even if my teacher is not there, ya kabhi kabhi teacher ko aane mein 15 minute late hota hai, she's in the principal's room, there is some other, you know, reason why the teacher is 15 minutes late, but the children are aware that agar 15 minute meri teacher late aati to mujhe karna kya hai us time, right? So in classrooms, which are learning classrooms, children do tend to have a well-defined routine. This doesn't mean that they have to be on the other end of the discipline. It just means that the children are aware on what they need to be doing. And in case of student engagement, there's another point which is called student talk. And once you go and look at this model yourself, you'll find. So it's very important what is the nature of talk that the students are engaging in, right? So is it talk on task? So supposing I'm sitting as a child in class, right? If this is the maximum, and there's nothing wrong, children will do that, right? But how much percentage in a class of half an hour is the child engaged in talk which is irrelevant to what is happening, and how much of it is relevant to what is happening? So it's called talk on task. जो आपको दिया हुआ है उसके लेके आप एक दूसरे से बात कर रहे हैं क्या? लेकिन वैसा बात करने के लिए टीचर को ऐसे रूटीन्स, प्रोसेसेस, सिस्टम्स, पेडागॉजी फॉलो करनी पड़ती है, बिकॉज़ ऑफ व्हिच द चाइल्ड विल टॉक, अदरवाइज चिल्ड्रन डोंट टॉक. एंड दैट्स बीन आवर एक्सपीरियंस सो फार इन वर्किंग विद टीचर्स. सो दिस इज अ नोटिसिंग फ्रेमवर्क दैट यू कुड यूज. दिस जस्ट वन कंक्लूडिंग पॉइंट दैट आई वांट टू मेक, रुचि, इज दैट व्हेन यू आर लुकिंग एट यूजिंग वीडियोस, राइट, इट्स नॉट इजी फॉर एनी ऑफ अस टू हैव आवर आवरसेल्व्स एग्जामिन्ड. Whether you're a teacher yourself, whether you're a teacher educator, or you know anyone who's just interested in the space of education, it's very, very frightening. कि मेरे को आके कोई मेरा ये करेगा. Now we have conducted hundreds of trainings, right? And हमारे workshops में जो हम pre-COVID physically करते थे, teachers हमको आके they used to tell us कि please don't use my video. They used to come and go and tell our coaches in the tea room, coffee machine. They used to come and tell us, please, ma'am, किसी और का ले लीजिए. आज के दिन मुझे छोड़ दीजिए, right? So it is that daunting, itna mushkil hai ki, you know, I'm going to be examined, to put yourself under the scanner, right? So we used to always take permissions from the teacher. It's okay, you don't want to show your video, fine. We used to ask for volunteers, right? So if you want to use, I mean, if you're a teacher yourself and you're using your video only for yourself, the question doesn't arise. But if you're going to have a peer collaboration, you're going to show yourself, there needs to be a culture of trust, right? And we are working with BMC and Zilla Parishad school teachers where the trust is very, very critical, especially when you're working in municipal schools, because wahan pe to there is a fear that, you know, like an agency like ours will come in video and then it will go to the newspapers, right? So that's the level of trust you need to build within the administrative system with the block education officer, ki hum aapke teachers ka video lenge to wo puri duniya ko nahi dikhane wale, right? And we are here to help. So to build a culture of trust, to give the teacher a lot of leeway and begin with where the teacher is. It's not about ye teacher achhi hai ya nahi hai. It's not about that. It's about whether this is a learning classroom or not. So use the videos only for figuring out ki how can the children learn better in this classroom, rather than, you know, the teacher did this right or wrong. So this has been our experience so far, and you know, we've used it as a central tool to coach teachers. So I think this is the last bit, and I think we've run over time. So Ruchi, I'm happy to sort of stop here, yeah. Let you take on whatever.
Thank you so much, Uma. I think all of us were so engrossed in discussion, and I'm really happy that today we had so many people sharing their points. And there are people who are saying that they didn't even notice the time that we have overshot it by that, and it is okay. We generally do overshot by 10 to 15 minutes, but it has been so interesting to hear everyone. And I just do hope that next week also, when we have the sharing session, that you come up with your own ideas. Do share it on our Telegram group, or you can look at CK website. I think teacher pages or YouTube link I had shared in the beginning. You can share it again in the Telegram group. You can select any of the videos, and you can even share your own interpretation of what you notice in that particular video. If you feel comfortable, you can share a classroom video or an online teaching video of your own in the Telegram group, and we can take it up for discussion in the next week's sharing session. So I do hope that you continue your enthusiastic participation in the sharing sessions also next week. Right now, I just want to thank you, Uma, so much. Shalini, Shalini is our student in
I'm going to share my email ID if anybody wants to know anything more about the videos or anything like that. You can write to me, you can visit our website. Please go to these videos, and these videos haven't been put up with the intention that these are perfect classrooms, right? Because it's a learning process. Every teacher improves incrementally. So aisa koi ekdam bhayankar transformation nahi hua hai, but we have tried to work with the teacher to make at least one innovative idea come forward bit by bit by bit. So aap zarur jaake, you know, please have a look at it.
Yeah, so Shalini, would it be possible for you to speak now?
Yes ma'am.
Can you please thank
so much Uma ma'am for such a wonderful session. Even for me as a student, it was a very thought-provoking session to understand how interactive and reflective we can make a classroom, and especially the kind of how we can use video also critically at the same time reflective. Thank you participants also, because after all, it is a two-side interaction we hope to have during this virtual session, and it was. And we also hope the next session, which will be more reflective from your side, you would be equally participating and let us know how and how insightful this session was for you. So the feedback form has already been shared in the chat. Please go through those feedback form and fill and share. You could share your thoughts, and even if you have some questions also, you can share there. And thank you again, everyone. Yeah.
Okay, great.
Thank you, Uma. Thank you, Uma, so much. And thank you, Shalini, for that. So please fill up the feedback form. I'm going to stop the recording right now. And we'll just hang on for a few more minutes in case if you have any problem in filling up the feedback form. Thanks a lot, Uma.
You're welcome.